Before we start finding who our primary audience is, it's good to remember why it's important to have them. They offer feedback, they help get your work exposure, and they help you validate what you're writing. Another great thing that having a primary audience does, or an online audience, is it helps you learn as you go. You learn what your readers like as you write, and you learn what you like as you write through feedback. When I say primary audience, what I mean is the people who are most likely going to connect and engage with your work. For instance, if you wrote a catalog on scroll saws and you were posting that on a stay-at-home mom's blog, you're less likely to get your primary audience than you would if you posted that catalog on scroll saws on some sort of home fix-it renovation site. So your primary audience are the people who you're writing for, who you're trying to target, and who you're trying to share your message with. You may find that there's two different types of people who will enjoy your work, your primary and your secondary audience. For the sake of today's lesson, we're going to focus on your primary audience, where to find them, how to engage with them, and how you guys can connect. You should be targeting the majority of your time to your primary audience. By understanding your primary audience, you can find more effective ways to reach them and engage with them. So there's some action you can take to try to understand and find your primary audience. And the first thing to do is to think about, if your book was in the library or in a bookstore, what department would it be in, what genre would it be, and what are the books that are around it? When you find out what genre and what area in a bookstore your book would be, through them you can understand who your primary audience is. For instance, if your book would be next to another major seller in that category, then you can look at the stats of that particular book, how it sold, did it sell primarily online, did it sell ebook mostly or paperback mostly, and you can start understanding who is buying that genre, where they're buying it, how they're buying it, and you can start finding and targeting where your primary audience would be. Another way to understand who your primary audience would be is simply through the protagonist of your story. Most likely, the age and the gender of your main character is who your primary readership will be. When you've found books that are in your genre that are similar to you, you can look up online on certain websites like Publishers Marketplace and Publishers Weekly, how those books are selling, who's reading them, the demographics of the readers, how they're buying them. Are they buying them primarily through ebook or paperback or hardcover? What websites they're buying them mostly from? You can look up how they're ranked and reviewed online, and you can see all the information that that author has paved for you for your book and your story. And then you can start to understand who's reading it, how they're reading it, where they're getting accessibility to that story. And that's most likely where you will find your primary audience. Once you think you've found your primary audience, it's a really good tool to research them and find things that they would be interested in that you can apply in your writing so that you can connect on that deeper level. There's some great questions you can ask yourself. What personalities seem to connect with them? What books do they like and why? What authors do they follow and how do they engage and interact with those authors? Are the authors they follow approachable or aloof? How do those authors present themselves in the media? All these questions will help you develop your brand and your connection to your primary audience. When trying to figure out your brand, you can still look at these other authors and ask yourself questions like, do they give tips to readers on writing or follow other authors themselves? What social media platforms are those authors on and how are they using them? It's really good to look at the colors and images and the way those authors write their bios across the different platforms they use. These will give you different tips and tricks on how to create your own brand and merchandising. And we're going to get more into that in another video. So if you find your primary audience, then you can start seeing those authors that they connect to, and you can see the roadmap that they've already laid for you that connects and engages with your primary audience in the way that would work for you. And you can start to emulate things that they're doing that also match your own style and voice and message and brand. There are four major genre groups or audiences online. That would be middle grade, young adult, new adult, which is a new genre, and adult. The ones that you will most likely see is young adult, new adult, and adult. There's trends in adult and new adult for authors to interact and engage with each other. So that's what you tend to see in those genres. Understanding your audience is really important. Once you've found your primary audience, don't feel like you have to be locked into that primary audience forever. As I've grown and learned as a writer, so has my story development and my audience. So it can grow and move with you. You can change and transition. Nothing's set in stone. It's just really good to understand that each novel or each story you write can have its own unique primary audience. Traditionally, writers are encouraged to find one genre, one niche primary audience, and nurture and develop and grow that. That will help your sales or your career grow, and you'll build a more specific platform, so it's easier to market to that. What writing online does is it opens up a potential audience, and you can engage and connect with people that you necessarily wouldn't. You can try new genres, try new writing styles, and start developing different primary audiences. Having multiple primary audiences is not necessarily conductive. You'll have to continue to write and satisfy them. So it is good to be really considerate and to think through what you're writing, why you're writing it, and who you're writing it for. Personally, myself, I experimented with a lot of different genres until I started to decide what I liked, who my primary audience was, who I connected the best with as readers, and what stories and what type of stories I like to write. When I first started writing online, I wasn't aware or conscious of who my primary audience is. One of my books is a middle grade book about mermaids, like I mentioned earlier, and that book only has a million reads, even though it's been online for almost 5 years. Where my newest work, The Cheater's Club, which is a new adult novel, received over 5 million reads in 1 year. So you can see that it's got a lot larger readership, and that has to do with the fact that I have learned and applied a lot of these techniques I'm talking about to how I write. So I write with my audience in mind now that I have an understanding of who they are, and I reference things that would be interesting to them, like movies and TV shows that they're watching, things that can connect and engage with that audience. So all these points and tips aside, you need to write the story that's organically yours. So taking into consideration who your primary audience is, I would do things like make sure that my story, each chapter or episode isn't so long that it would bore a reader who's reading from a phone. Most of my primary audience is reading from their cell phones or their tablets. So I'll make sure that my chapter is punchy and engaging and short, and so it's enough to keep their interest the whole time through. It doesn't mean that I have to drop commercial references in each chapter or change my language to suit them, but it just means that I have to be aware of who I'm writing to, how they're reading it, and express my story in a way that would best relate to my readers. I like to believe that you should write where your platform meets your passion, and that's where you'll see the most exponential growth and success. If you're still exploring and wondering who your primary audience is or what sort of genres you want to write in, a really great exercise is to take a paragraph that you've already written and stylize it for three different primary audiences. For instance, write it once thinking that priests or inmates or your grandma or your mother will be reading it, or a teenage girl, and each time keeping that particular primary reader in your mind when you go through and you rewrite that particular paragraph. Don't be afraid to make changes, because these should read differently. Depending on who your main character is, their point of view will be different and their references will be different. We talked about writing your story and tailoring it with your primary audience in mind. Now we're going to talk about merchandising yourself and your work.